Hello and welcome to Demo Reel. We are on the Xbox this week. It occurred to me we haven't really been on the Xbox for a little while, so I thought we'd come back. We're opening up here with the trailer for, it looks like, Dragon Ball Z Sagas. I'm just gonna go ahead and skip past this. If this disc is like any of the others, yeah, there it is. We'll get to see it again on the menu anyway. And actually, Dragon Ball Z Sagas gets a lot of attention. It looks like they've got, yeah, there's two videos and then the trailer that we're watching play on the side right now. This is interesting. They're really hyping that up. But it's not amongst our playable demos. We'll go ahead and hop in here. Up first, we have Destroy All Humans. Aliens invade Earth and attempt to destroy all humans. Sound familiar? All your brains are belong to us. Oh. Ah, that hurts. Okay, Lego Star Wars. We've got a good feeling about this. With lightsaber in hand, slice your enemies to pieces. Literally. I guess it's meant to not be graphics and so Legos, right? FlatOut. Go off-roading or go through the windshield. Either way, the physics are great and the action's a blast. And that one's just graphic, just because. Dead to Rights 2. Jack's back, baby. I don't know who Jack is. And he's brought his faithful canine companion Shadow with him. Don't know who that is. Whether by guns or growls, you put the fear of death into your enemies. I've never played Dead to Rights. I know nothing about it. Juice. Juiced ignites the world of tuner cars and pink slip racing into its fiery new entry into the street racing scene. Take it for a spin. I think we've either played Juiced or just seen it like as a video before. I definitely know we've seen it's shown up on the show before. And last but not least is Xbox Live Arcade. Prepare for a mega-huge, jam-packed bundle of classic arcade goodness with our exclusive Xbox Live Arcade sampler. Enjoy up to 12 demos. Wow, 12 demos, including Bankshot Billiards, Bejeweled, Guardian, and Alien Sky. So we'll have to contend with that eventually. But first, let's just jump on in with Destroy All Humans here. And I very distinctly remember playing a demo for this game on the PlayStation 2, so at some point, we'll get to play this again. Probably the same demo. We'll see when it loads up here. But I remember thinking this game was cool when I was a kid. I'm not really expecting to have the same opinion now. I'm a lot more discerning, I guess, with what games I want to say are good. But at the time, just the idea of like running around causing mayhem was cool. So press start to launch, I should say. And there's a little spaceship with our little big-headed alien in it. This game, I feel like, is... I remember feeling when the game came out that it was the tie-in game to Mars Attacks. Like, not literally, but it just felt like kind of how I would have expected that game to play. Unless, of course, in the tie-in game to Mars Attacks, you would play as the humans. But I don't know why you would do that. But anyway, it's just like this really comedic take on like alien invasion, like kind of 50s throwback sci-fi type stuff. Lots of abducting cows and stuff. You see the cows here, of course. Obviously our character is like a big-headed alien, although it makes more sense here than in Area 51 since this game isn't taking itself seriously. But they just kind of play up all the typical sci-fi, like cheesy sci-fi tropes that you would expect. There he is, our little Invader Zim guy.
Order box to Cryptosporidium 137. Come in, Cryptosporidium.
Crypto here. How's the view from the safety of the mothership?
Very funny. Let's just say I'm glad I'm up here and you're down there.
Loathsome little planet.
Now, Crypto! To ensure this invasion runs smoothly, it is imperative we identify the dominant life forms on this world. Those lactating bovoids are likely candidates.
Surely you don't mean those foul-smelling gas bags beyond the fence?
Yes, I'm afraid I do.
But they're covered in nipples.
Now, Cryptosporidium!
Okay, I don't ever get that. Okay, like... For some reason, in these types of comedic sci-fi things, aliens land and the very first thing they see is what they assume is the main life form. Like, I don't know, that's not what we would do if we landed on an alien planet. But this functions as our tutorial here. So yeah, I can hold L and hit A and I can scan their brain. But of course, since they're cows, they're all thinking moo, not not the most thought-provoking bunch here.
They eat with their mouths. Ugh, I think I'm going to be violently ill. Attention, Earth creature. This planet is now part of the Furon Empire. Your benevolent masters welcome you. At this time, we wish to abduct you for the purpose of scientific research. The procedure will be protracted and invasive. Do you have any objections? Earth creature, I am addressing you. Respond or be vaporized.
You already read their minds. You know that that's the only thing they're thinking.
I don't care how many stomachs you have. I don't have time for this.
Okay. Use psychokinesis to mutilate the creatures. Okay, so here's where the chaos comes in. So I always thought this was kind of neat, especially when I was a kid and I was a lot more violently oriented. But yeah, I can just kind of move them around by using the D-pad. There, I threw it, I think. I can pick up other stuff too, that's cool. I didn't really remember that. That's a lot heavier than a cow. I had a hard time picking that up. So am I supposed to do this with all of them, I guess? I don't know. Just hit Y and throw them, I guess. I don't know. There we go. Just throwing cows around. It's a lot of... I don't know. This is kind of boring. Obviously, this... Oh, wait. Why does he talk about me in the third person? Like, he's talking directly to the player, the guy running the tutorial here. The alien that was, like, talking to us through, the hologram or whatever. It's kind of weird that he's talking directly to me, because he says, like, the concentration represents Crypto's psychic abilities. It's like, well, aren't you talking to him? I don't know. But, okay. So, alright, here's the first human.
Martha, you didn't tell me we was having barbecue for dinner? Wait a minute, that ain't steak, that's holy mother of... Martha, give me the shotgun!
Okay, so obviously that dialogue's supposed to be funny, but... I don't know, doesn't it have to be funny? Or doesn't it have to make sense to be funny? So the guy walks out here, he sees this thing, like, and he thinks it's a steak? Like, what? Like, okay, I gotta get this guy's brain, hold on. Okay. It's kind of like the alien, assuming that humans the cows are the dominant life form. It's like, it just doesn't make any sense. Why would he think that? Okay, whatever. I got his brain. I don't know what that means.
Come on back! You gotta see this! They got a talking horse on the TV! I ain't never seen nothing like... Ah! Loud green spaceman!
Ah! I'm not green, I'm gray.
I'm not green.
Oh, he said the same thing. Yeah, why would she say that? We're clearly not green. So I guess I'm supposed to kill the farmhands. Oh, there's other people here. I didn't see them in the, cutscene, so. There we go. Get that guy. He shot me. Am I dead? Okay. I don't know. I should be dead, you would think. I guess I've got some kind of space armor on. I don't know. He shot me again. So the shotgun blast, like, knocks me down. I can't tell. Is that affecting my health? I think so, yeah. I would assume so anyway, but... Okay, so... Now what? The police, I guess? Okay. It's, yeah, Martha Kent here is going to see the cops.
Evening, Ms. Turnipseed.
Her name is Turnipseed?
Farmer Dixon over the other side of the state road said he heard some pretty strange noises coming from over this way.
What is that? A new silo?
Crypto! That human law enforcement officer is attempting an unauthorized entry of your spacecraft. If those P-brains were to get their hands on your quantum deconstructor, they could rip a hole in the space-time continuum!
So I made an Invader Zim joke earlier, but I think our liaison guy talking to us is the voice of Invader Zim. Like, it sounds just like him, right? So I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. I'll just shoot the cops, I guess? I don't know. I got Martha. I didn't mean to. Miss Turnipseed. I can't believe that's her name. It doesn't make any sense. Again, the comedy has to at least make a little bit of sense, right? Okay. So I think I killed everyone. That's all right. I don't feel great about it, but whatever. It's hard to feel guilty, though. I guess that's part of the one upside to everyone being completely unrealistic. I don't feel guilty for killing these people because they don't seem like real people, like even a little bit. So, but then again, I don't really seem like a real alien. But I'm in my spaceship. I've got a death ray. I can destroy human dwellings. This has escalated really quickly. Like, we're on full-scale invasion now. I was not expecting this. So, destroy the barn, I guess? There it goes. Okay. Yeah. So this destruction stuff, it's working pretty well for this era. Like, a lot of the games I've played from this time period don't work quite this well when it comes to destroying things, though it also doesn't come up that often. But, I don't know. I remember being really impressed by how much destruction we could do when I played this demo as a kid. And this is, I'm pretty sure, the exact same demo I played on the PS2. So, yeah. Just laser this house some more. I'm just kind of tapping the laser button. When I hold it, it seems to run out pretty quickly. There we go. There it goes. Okay. So let's see. What is this little orange box? I don't know. Oh, the military's here. This is getting really out of hand. It feels like the entire game's happening right now. Like, if this is all the tutorial, then what's the rest of the game? I guess just rinse and repeat.
The human military-industrial complex. We can't allow them to alert their leaders to our presence. Exterminate them! Now!
Open fire!
But I mean, the military is going to realize that their platoon they sent out stopped existing, right? But anyway, that looks like that's all we get to play, because now that it's playing this trailer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this program to bring you breaking news from the observatory at Rockwell.
I do kind of like the trailer, though. 20 years of broadcasting, I like the way this is set up. Words.
I can only describe what I'm seeing as not from this Earth. Something is emerging out of the spacecraft. It's raising its hand. Perhaps a sign of peace. No! We are under attack!
Yeah, it looks like more of the same. Manipulate humans into submission. Oh, I guess there's mind control stuff. Yeah, so I liked the idea of, like, chaotic sandbox type games, which is how this is advertising itself. So I always thought I would like it as a kid, and now, I mean, I don't have that same taste anymore, but it still looks fun enough, I guess. Like, it's a little mean-spirited, but I think that's kind of the point. You know, you don't always play games to be benevolent. So, yeah, I don't know. It's fine, I guess.
Ladies and gentlemen, due to technical difficulties, we are unable to continue the broadcast from the Rockwell Observatory.
Pathetic humans.
Dun dun dun. One giant step on mankind. Okay. Yeah, so that's destroy all humans. Hypnotize, abduct, and also laser. Lots of laser from from the demo. Terrorize, vaporize. Yeah, there we go. Is that a giant? Oh, we can grow giant. Okay. I'm pretty sure that's what I'm looking at there. He's standing next to a building. It comes up to his neck. So, that'd be kind of cool.
So, our next game here is LEGO Star Wars. And we've played this game before on the PlayStation 2. I think in episode 29. And yeah, it looks like it's going to be the same one, this episode 1 thing. I really like how they always get the sound and music right in these games. And the look, too. It feels really authentic, which is probably one of the reasons why this franchise has done well. But I remember when we played it before, getting really bored. And we'll see if we have that problem this time. That may have just been, I don't know, maybe I was just in a bad mood. But Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, Chapter 1, Negotiations. As everyone knows, negotiations are the absolute best part of Star Wars. Turmoil has engulfed the Galactic Republic with a blockade of deadly battleships. The Trade Federation has stopped all shipping to the small planet of Naboo. The Supreme Chancellor has dispatched the Knight. Qui-Gon Jinn. Yeah, okay. And Obi-Wan. Whatever. It's episode 1. I think most of us probably know the plot to episode 1 by now. But anyway, we're doing the opening scene here. It's going to dump us into the spaceship, and we get to walk around as Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan. There we go. Okay, for a second I thought it wasn't going to load. It just kind of stopped there. But here we are. I remember being really excited to play this demo because I've always heard good things about the LEGO games. the not just Star Wars, but Batman and The Hobbit, Lord of the Rings stuff, and probably others. And I always thought they had a lot of potential because, you know, I like Legos. I don't know many people who dislike Legos. Most people either like them or are neutral to them. But they provide themselves well to comedy. We saw a little bit of that there. But then, I don't know, something about this game didn't really work for me. Looks like, yeah, it's telling me I can insert a controller. I pressed B and it made all the chairs dance. While it plays the music from the cantina. I don't know why. I guess it's just a little inside joke there. Hold B to use force powers. So, I know there was things we could open in there, but I one of the things I remember about this demo, possibly one of the reasons why I got bored with it, is that it took a really long time, a lot longer than I thought it should. We just ended up playing it for, it felt like hours, but it was probably like 20 minutes, but I remember getting really bored with it by the end. So far it's pretty much how I remember it. I like the cutscenes a lot. And maybe this is just the case of me preferring the aesthetic but not really wanting to play a game set in it. Like, maybe if this was a movie, like, I know Lego has done some movies, not just the Lego movie, but like some direct-to-DVD stuff. So, I don't know, maybe this would have worked better there, where they could have still made all the jokes, but not taken quite so long to get to them. Or, I don't know. Let's see. Yeah. So we're collecting all these coins. I don't actually know why. Doesn't really make sense. Like we're collecting them because it's a video game, but like it's not like in Star Wars Episode 1, Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan running around picking up coins out of vents or something. Let's see. Hold on. It's giving me instructions here, but I haven't been reading them. Walk up to a friendly character and press Y to take control of them. That's right. So, yeah. Droids can open certain doors. Right, I remember this. Okay, so... is it this door? Yeah. Special ability, open door. Yeah, and this is another thing that seems like it would be cool, that you can switch between characters and they can do different things, but when you have a character whose sole purpose is to open doors, it's just like kind of a needless puzzle. It's not even a puzzle, that's giving it too much credit. It's just kind of this needless busy work to switch between characters. I just don't understand why I have to be a droid to open a door. I just want to get through the level. I don't want to run around swapping between characters. So yeah, I just have lots of little nitpicky gripes like that. Nothing... I locked myself in here. Huh. Come on. Okay, so I hold it long enough and then it turns into, like, a table here. Okay, and I can jump on to get part 1 of 10, whatever those are. All 10 Lego canisters. For a secret game code. I don't think we'll do that. Like, we might. I'm definitely going to grab when I see them, like I see that one up there. And if I can... I tried to do a double jump. It didn't quite work. I don't know. Let's take care of these guys, and then we'll figure out how to get that thing. I remember that aspect of the game in the previous demo, but I don't think we did it then either. I'm pretty sure. I'd be surprised if we did. I certainly don't remember it. So, yeah, I'm just kind of moving this over here. I don't know, just trying to stack some stuff up. There we go. Is this good enough? I don't think I can get there from this. Sometimes I do a really big jump, and sometimes I don't. I don't know what causes it. Let's move this over there, too. Whoa, somebody's shooting me. Makes it hard to move stuff when I'm being shot at. Also makes it hard to get the guy that's shooting me when I can't do a jump in regular attack. It seems like every time I jump and do an attack, I end up doing some kind of falling down attack, so I can't attack somebody that's up higher than me. So I don't know if is this going to work? Okay. I started to wonder if maybe I should have put... I didn't want to do that. I'm just trying to figure out how to jump up onto this thing. Hold on. Yeah, I guess maybe I should have put this one down first? No, come on, keep moving. There we go. Just sit down there. Well, I destroyed that droid by accident. I didn't mean to. I wonder if that happens to Jedis a lot. You're just trying to move some box or something and you accidentally blow up a poor innocent droid. It just happens to be there. Speaking of droids, this silver 3PO unit here, I don't know the actual model number of it, is following us around after we took control of it. I don't really remember doing that before. But anyway, if I stack them up like this, I should be able to jump up to the bigger one and then onto this one. Yeah. And now can I jump over here? No, I still can't do it. Why can't I do it? I feel like I should be able to at this point. Okay, I made it. I just messed the jump up before. So, yeah, now let's see if I can... Hold on. Just reconfigure this slightly over to the left here so I can jump up here. And I need to be the droid to open this. Well, shoot. Can the droid even jump up there? I don't think he can. Maybe I should... Can I pick him up? No. Let me just try... Yeah, the droid cannot jump. So how the heck am I supposed to get up there? He can't jump and I can't seem to move him with my force powers. So we just can't get up there. Okay, well, I'll accept that, whatever. Let's just keep moving. I don't want to sit here doing puzzles all day. Let's see. I do feel like we're moving through this quicker than we did before. Like, I remember this part, but it seems like it took a while to get here. Maybe I'm misremembering. But yeah, I think I spent a little bit too much time exploring the earlier hallway areas in the last time we played, and that might be part of why it took so long. That might be part of why I got so bored with it. Because I'm not bored with it right now. I'm not sitting here like, oh, I can't believe I'm still playing Star Wars. But at the same time, I'm not like having the time of my life or anything. I don't know. I think if the game's selling point is its sense of humor, then I think, I don't think this demo does a good job getting that across. It's like, we saw some Legos fall apart earlier, and there was like a little bit of a joke with that, like kind of a slapsticky thing, which honestly, slapstick is the area where Lego can really shine, because you can do all kinds of cruel things to your characters, and they'll be fine. They aren't hurt, they just fall apart. My droid lost his arm, looks like. I wonder when that happened. I'm just kind of seeing what I can force around here, forcing things. Blew up another droid by accident. Sorry, I don't know why that happens. Stacking stuff up, I assume I'll need it if it's letting me do this. So the way the force works, stop that. I don't actually have that much control over what I do. I just look at something and hold B, and then it automatically does whatever it's supposed to do. I don't know how obvious that is watching. But yeah, I'm not like doing anything here but holding B next to things. So the force power, like, I like that they incorporated it, because like, you can't really make a game where you play as a Jedi and not incorporate some kind of force powers. Obviously this is Force Unleashed or something like that, but I don't know, it doesn't feel like I'm actually doing a whole lot here. Hold on, there we go. I deactivated that. There's a problem with the disc I'm using, it may be dirty. Oh, crap. Well, I ran into a technical error, whatever. If you want to see more of this, watch episode 29. I play the PS2 version of the demo, it's the same thing. I'm just a little bit more lost there. But let's go ahead and move on to our next game. Alright, so we're going to move along here with FlatOut, a game I'm not too familiar with, but it appears to be some kind of racing or driving game. There's a tire to prove that. I feel really bad about cutting out Lego Star Wars as quickly as we did there, but, you know, if it wasn't for the fact that I'd already played that demo, I probably would have rebooted it and gone back to that point. But anyway, hopefully we won't have many more problems like that. Let's just do a quick race here. Looks like we only have one car option. We'll go automatic. Okay, it looks like we've got three stadiums here. So, this is looking kind of familiar. We might have played this before. I'm trying to remember. Let's go ahead and do this Finchley challenge. Depending on how long the races end up being, we'll probably try and do all three of them. But if not, I don't think it's going to be a big deal. We'll just see how it goes here. But I'm always kind of on edge when playing on this Xbox because the person who gave it to me had modded it, or somebody they knew had modded it. So it's been tampered with, and I don't completely trust it. I press A to start driving because I'm used to other control schemes, but it's actually the right trigger to put gas on here. So, yeah, it's hard to tell if we've played this game because, I can't tell if we've played this game before because it looks like a racing game, but we've played a lot of games that look like this. Some of them completely indistinguishable from one another to me, to a non-racing game fan. I will say this one is a lot harder to control than most of them. Like, I don't know what's going on here, but I barely tap the analog stick and it just really swerves. But then when I try to make a sharp turn, I don't know, I can't seem to get it to do anything I want. It's really, really weird. Hold on. White to reset? Okay. So, thankfully it does have a reset button. That's good. That helps a little bit. But honestly, in a racing game, unless you're playing with a bunch of other people who are just as bad as you are, going off the road at all, or through the windshield like that, we just completely killed this ragdoll, makes it impossible to win. Like, once you've gone off the road once in a race against AI, there's nothing you can do. And at this point, we seem to be to where if we tap anything with our car, we just go flying out now. Because we just barely touched that tree, and then our guy just went flying out like a mannequin there. But I can hit these trees okay. I think those are logs. Yeah, our car is totaled because I can't keep it on the track no matter what I do. So this is not good. I don't know how much of it's the game's fault, honestly, because I'm always bad at racing games, but I feel like this is going way worse than usual, and I don't know, I feel like there's nothing I can do to control this car. I feel like I'm watching a video of somebody playing it really badly, because no matter what I do, it doesn't react the way I think it will. I don't know. Are we getting close to the lap part? I want to hit that ramp better. Oh well. In our current condition, I don't think that's a good idea, but... Man, we're still on lap one. How is this possible? I have to wait for him to land before I can reset. That's kind of annoying. I wish I could reset as soon as he hit, but... No, the penalty wouldn't be enough then. I don't know. We're being lapped by everybody, so who fucking cares? But... trying to kill this guy, but it's not working. I just want to drive him off the road. I'm trying to find some kind of something to care about in this game, because, like I said, the second we went off the road, it became impossible for us to do well, and then it's just been one after the other ever since then. And, it's so hard to come back, from little things in this game. So, if you, completely wreck the car, you can reset, but if you get stuck on, a cone or a tire or something, you've got to just spin your wheels and hope that it lets you get off of it. But, man, well, for some reason, let me reset there. I don't know what the deal is there. But, yeah, I don't know. It's, this game is just incredibly frustrating for me. And I was in a really good mood coming in here because I had just gotten out of playing the rest of the LEGO Star Wars demo. I was feeling pretty good. I was like, yeah, I didn't have to play all of that demo again because I was kind of not looking forward to it. So it's not even like... Sometimes when I play these demos, I'm just in a bad mood at the start because of some shitty game I played right before it. But in this case, that wasn't going on. It's just this game feels impossible to play. I don't know. I'm trying to remember if we've had another racing game that I just couldn't get the hang of. And I guess there's been a few. I think we played a NASCAR game pretty early on that I couldn't keep the car going straight to save my life. I don't know what the deal was there. So, my solution here is to just lightly tap on the gas, and I'm still having a really hard time controlling it. I have no idea how you could possibly play this game going full speed. What is going on? Here, whatever, I'm going this way. I know it's not the right... even just tapping the gas and going kind of slow and playing it really safe, it's still impossible for me to control this car. Look at this. What's going on here? I don't know. I guess... Wait, why was that log being pushed by that car? I don't know. I think they're lapping us again here. Because why wouldn't they be? So there are some things I think are well done here. I think the game looks very nice. I don't want to like give it too much shit because I'm bad at it. I recognize that I'm part of the problem here. It's like it's not all me, I don't feel like, but I am part of the problem. But I think the game looks nice, and I think the car damage that it's doing is really, really good. I think like the car looks realistically damaged for everything we've put it through. I do think it overemphasizes some of the wrecks we've had. Like, it feels like sometimes things happen for no real reason. I don't know. Like, we're driving through these fences like they're nothing, but I can't drive, like, through a tire or... I don't know. I feel like it's a little bit inconsistent, but for the most part, the wrecks and damage and all of that are fine, which, given the way that they over-animate the, like, guy flying out of the windshield and stuff like that, I feel like that's probably a selling point of this game. I would, like, judging from the way this game is playing, I imagine the advertising was in part advertising the wrecks you could have. Like, we've played games like that that do that a lot more, like, with explosions and stuff. But even so, like, if any game where the driver can fly out of the car wants you to have wrecks, I used to play a game, I don't remember what it was called. I used to play a racing game in arcades when I was a kid that would do that. That was, it was a lot simpler graphics than this, but it would throw the driver out of the car when you would wreck it. And I feel like the way the game was set up, that's what you were supposed to be doing more than winning races. But that's kind of how I feel playing this. Like, I don't know. Not to say that we're playing the game properly, but that's kind of how I feel. Another thing, though, I do like the way the environments interact with our car. Like the logs falling, the way the logs move when we hit them, or the tires like we just hit there, I feel like those elements work well. I still feel like our car overreacts to things sometimes. We're about to explode here. I don't know. I can't even go the right direction. That's how ridiculous this is. So it's taken us 7 fucking minutes, but we finished the race. Okay, if it takes us back to the menu here, I might look at the other tracks, but I'm not... Yeah, it looks like it's... Actually, I'm not going to play the other ones. Additional professional handling mode, 16 fully upgradable muscle cars, 36 massively interactive tracks, some other stuff. Alright, so this is Dead to Rights 2, and I think I mentioned this on the menu, but I don't actually know for sure what Dead to Rights is. Like, I guess I could have looked it up, but it's one of those games that I recognize the name. And now that I saw the Namco logo earlier, I feel like I should probably know it a bit better than I do. But, I don't know, I think it's a shooting game, or like a, kind of like a Grand Theft Auto or True Crime type game. But I don't know, so we'll see. Or maybe something like more like Mad Max. Or Mad Max, what am I talking about? Max Payne. But anyway, we've got this cutscene here where a guy just walked in on a convenience store robbery, it looks like. Guys in a variety of masks here. Yeah, I'm guessing that's us there. Yeah, I guess so, since he's beating them up. So, yeah, so we are kind of like some kind of generic type badass. I don't know what sort of guy this he is, running around in his turtleneck beating people with baseball bats. But what is this guy doing with all these knives? Like, what kind of robbers are these? I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen the news and seen like guys throwing knives and shit, but maybe this is some kind of special criminals, I don't know. They just seem awfully well organized for hitting a convenience store. Oh, and I have a dog? Okay, that's cool, I like dogs. I think I mentioned that in the text on the menu now that I think about it, though. Oh good, he paid for the beer. Alright, so... Alright, so I have a pretty good idea of what we're in store for after seeing that. I doubt the gameplay will be anything like the video, or at least not that smooth, but I like the dog. I like that we have a dog. That's cool. So, yeah, new gamer options are only options. Normal, and then it looks like we don't get any of these things down here. I saw things for, like, extra life and extra ammo. I guess those are extra things to make help you toggle the difficulty or tweak it to your specifications. So I don't know... why all of a sudden I'm fighting security guards? Seems like the opposite direction from the opening video. But, yeah, it's taking me a little while here to figure out how to... Okay, so I was pressing right trigger, because that's usually fire, but it turns out that's just the auto-target. So I was just auto-targeting on and off these guys, which is kind of embarrassing, but whatever. I think I've made that mistake before. Did we do that in James Bond or something? So that sounds like something I've done before. Actually, this does kind of remind me of the first part of that James Bond demo we had a few weeks ago. Obviously, not the motorcycle part. That's a bit of a shame. Would have liked to relive that, but let's see. Where do we go? I don't know. Can we open any of these doors? Well, I just shot it. Okay, so that says keep out, so obviously I can't go in there. Oh wait, maybe I can go up here. Hold on. How do I... Can I jump? Or I can climb with X. Okay. So, yeah. It's taking me a little bit to get used to these controls. I don't know exactly what I'm doing. And I'm not sure what we're supposed to be doing, because, like... So the opening video portrayed us as, like, a vigilante, right? Maybe, or at least a little bit like a vigilante. But now we're just, like, raiding some kind of warehouse or something? I don't know. It's showing us this room. Were there supposed to be people in there? Because it just showed, like, an empty room, and then all of a sudden I'm being shot at. I don't know why the game completely stopped to show us this room. I didn't see... was it showing us a skylight or something? I don't know. Maybe it was showing us where we were supposed to go. Well, shoot. What? I just exploded. What happened? So he shot me and I was stunned, it looked like. Or maybe I just have a really long death animation. But, like, when he shot me, I was stunned all of a sudden. And then, I don't know. I just sort of, was standing around for a while, unable to do anything, and then he killed me, and then I exploded. That was a real shocker. Okay, so let's get some ammo or weapons or whatever from these guys. We didn't make it very far, so I'm not even bothering to cut anything out here. Let's see. Oh, I can roll over those. That's kind of cool. I don't know. I should probably be finding cover or something. I don't know. Can I, like, is there a way to, like, look around the corner? I guess not. Some games will let you hide behind corners and stuff, but this one doesn't seem to, or if it does, I have no idea how. Which is weird, because there's a lot of enemies here. And again, I'm not sure what they are. If they're cops or security guards or what. They're wearing some kind of uniform, and they look pretty official, but we didn't get... At least I didn't see any kind of, like, dossier or anything explaining to us. So now, what am I looking at here? Yeah, there's a helicopter up there, I guess. I assume that's what it's trying to show us. But then it shows a couple of other angles I don't really get. Whatever. Gotta keep moving through here. Try not to let myself get killed again. There's a lot of guys up here. It might be part of why I was having trouble. Alright. I haven't figured out for sure. The top bar is my health bar. That's good to know. I'm pretty close to death again. I don't know, I run out of ammo really quickly. There we go. We're about to die. I haven't seen anything that looks like a first aid kit or something, though. Let's see. Did I get everybody? It's not letting me auto-target on anyone anymore. Thought I saw another guy up there, but I guess I got him. Okay. Oh, wait, no. Maybe not. Okay, I just couldn't see him. Great, we're gonna die again. There we go. Well, at least we died faster that time. Okay, whatever, I'm done. Let's move on to our next game. So this is Juiced. I'm pretty sure I know I've seen this logo before. I'm not sure if we've played it. I remember there was a Jam Pack disc that had, like, a video about Juiced or something. I don't know. I just remember spending a little while trying to read it because it was really small. The vehicle driving depicted in this game may not be entirely realistic and could be dangerous in real life. Okay, we'll have to keep that in mind. Don't try this at home or on the road, kids. Let's see. Uses Bink Video. That's good. Okay, just some copyright info. Anyway, so we've got THQ here, which are pretty hit and miss. I don't think I've ever played a THQ game that I loved. I'm sure they must have had some really good ones, but the more I think about it, I either hate them or am okay with them, it feels like. And this all looks really familiar, so maybe we have actually played a demo before, and I just can't remember.
Home to the country's toughest street racing crews.
This sounds really
familiar.
You'll
get to meet them all, but you'll need to do more than just win. You'll need to impress them with all your tricked-out automobiles, challenge them for ownership, entertain them with slick maneuvers and cool style, and win the best-looking machines for yourself. Now let's meet TK, leader of the Urban Maulers, and get you on the line.
Okay, yeah, I'm positive
hey,
we've played this
I'm now. TK. Welcome to Angel City. So you want a race, huh? Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna loan you some wheels for a couple days. If you bend my...
Okay, let's skip through this.
Look at these two babies. This is gonna...
Yeah, I remember all this pretty well now. I didn't remember that this was juice or anything about it. Yeah, okay, so we've got a bet here. Let's raise it. I have nothing to lose.
I'll race you.
Okay, so... Right, alright. Alright, this game has like a... It's like a racing game with a role-playing element. I remember that now. So, you would do these street races and you can place bets on your races. And that's the way you can kind of earn money and respect and have... It has kind of this social aspect to it with the other street racers. And that's kind of all I remember. I remember the gameplay was fine. I don't remember anything real specific about it, but I don't remember hating it. I kind of like the big juiced ad right there, just in case we forgot we were playing the demo version. So yeah, we've got some stuff on the line here, but it's a demo, so... once again, I pressed A to throttle instead of right trigger, but so we started off a little bit late, but that's okay, we were never going to win this. Anyway, let's see, slow down! Whoa, way too early, okay. Dropping back. I lost a lot of respect for that, which I should have, because that was stupid. If I was watching a street racer and he did that, I would have been like, what? I don't even know what I'm saying. But anyway, so yeah, I had forgotten about this game, but I remember it pretty well now. It's weird I forgot it, because it's not as generic as like whatever that racing game was we played earlier in this episode that I already forgot the name of. Like, stylistically, this is similar to a couple of games we've played. We played a street racing game on the Xbox once with Alex D20 where we were able to race as ambulances. Like, that wasn't the main thing in the game, but it was an option that we could race as ambulances. And I remember, like, this game looks similar to that one to me, partly because we're street racing, but it's also got, like, the arrows to help you know which way to go. But this one is a lot more linear. Like, I think in that game we could take other routes if we wanted. I think it was fairly open, but in this one, we're pretty much stuck on this track, doing whatever we're doing now. Oh, since we're catching up, that's really surprising, actually. I wonder what happened. Catching up. Looking at the map, it doesn't look like we're that close to catching up, though, because, like, I've made no good turns yet, which is the main thing that's slowing us down. Is, like, I guess that one was okay, but it would be nice if I knew how to drift. I don't. I've tried a couple of different buttons and none of them have really worked. Okay, no, I just braked really hard. I didn't really drift. I want to drift. I know we're not in Tokyo, but I want to drift. Okay, brake now! Oh, okay, so if I hold on to the gas, it'll tell me when to brake. That's good to know. Be finished. That's not good. Yeah, I know we're dropping back. He's done. It's over. We lost. Like, now we're just going for a time. Wait. Oh, wait. Was there more than one car? I only saw one other car. Whoa. Okay. I will say, this game controls way better than the game we were playing before. I was saying then that it wasn't entirely the game's fault, that part of it was me. I think that's a pretty good idea of how I play on a game that controls well. And I think the difference is pretty obvious. Like, yeah, I was all over the place there too, but not nearly as bad. Anyway, I hit continue because I remember there was some other stuff we could look at. We could have just quit the demo, but I wanted to take a look at... Yeah.
You're still gonna have to pay.
There's all that money. This face is pretty well animated too for this, like, time period. I wonder why all this stuff's being doled out. Like, there was only two people involved, I thought. Me and that bald guy. I don't know why all this other stuff's happening. These other people with zero respect are all losing it. I'm losing respect with them. Okay. Because they didn't like my, okay, that guy was impressed with because I bet so much on it. like 9 points versus, like, 290 of the one guy that has any respect for me. That bald guy. Okay, so yeah, this is the other aspect of it. So you have to repair your car, and that costs money, so that's one thing you need money for, and then you can also customize it. We have lots of different options here. I'm sure you can kind of guess most of them. I like that we have a gradient we can work with here instead of just choosing from like a list. I don't know. It doesn't matter because we're not going to be playing this game for more than a few more minutes here. But metallic color. Oh, yeah. I can get like a good fade here. Yeah. Okay. Let's make that intense. So, yeah. I'm just kind of showing you some of the options here. So you don't have to go back and watch the first time I played this, which I think was pretty much exactly like this. I don't think there's a whole lot that's changed. But there's a tuning shop, a dynamo meter? I don't know what this is. Let's see what it lets us do here. Start dyno test. Okay, I don't know enough about cars to know what's going on here. But anyway, there's some kind of test you can do, whatever. If you know anything about it, then you know. Let's see, go race. Do we have the option of doing a different race than that one? Here, yeah, okay. I don't remember doing more than one race when we played this before. Memory's not great, but let's see. Oh, why is nitrous? We should know that. Okay. Yeah, alright. I don't think there's a whole lot else there we need to know. Okay, so it's like a daytime of the same track, looks like. But there's other cars now. There was three other cars. So that's kind of nice. But this will probably be all we do of this race. Or this game. The races don't tend to last that long, so we can get through pretty quickly, especially if it's only two laps like the last one. Oh, I guess this one's four? Or, no wait, that's a placement. Where's the... Okay, three laps. Sorry, that's not too bad. So yeah, oh man, somebody's nitrousing already. I don't know how he does that. There we go. Okay, that was better. Still way too sharp. I should have let up on the gas a little bit. But we didn't hit any walls, which is a huge improvement. Slow down, break down. Okay. Ah, still too early though. Okay, still too early. So yeah, it's gonna be more of the same here. But I'm kind of enjoying this. It's nice to play a racing game that I feel controls well. We don't play very many. So many of the racing games we play, I feel like I have no control over the car. Like most of the time, they're not as bad as that. I wish I could remember what it was called, but whatever that dirt track racing game we played earlier was with the logs and stuff. Like, that game was awful. There was a chore to get through that, but this is fun. It's still not my type of racing game. I think I've mentioned this number of times here. And I can't even talk right now. A great number of times on Demo Reel I've talked about that I prefer more cartoony or unrealistic racing games. Either something like your Mario Karts or your F-Zero, or something that makes me feel like I'm doing something extraordinary, because I know for a lot of people, racing by itself is extraordinary, and that's fine for them, but it's not how I feel. Like right now, I don't feel like I'm doing anything too great. It's not anything I'd ever do in real life, but it's just not exciting for me, as much as like if I was throwing bombs at people or flying, or I don't know, any number of things that could have been more entertaining than just driving around on the street. But all the same, you know, this is, if I'm going to play a more realistic racing game, I'd rather play this than a lot of them that we've done on this show. I have a hard time with this draw distance. Like, it's telling me when turns are coming up, but I can't always tell exactly where I can turn. So, I've made a few times where I've turned way too soon and I've ended up hitting a wall. And you guys have noticed that, I'm sure. It's happened a number of times here. But it's partly because I can't tell exactly when I can turn. So that's one thing that would be nice if I had a little bit clearer idea. And that might be partly because of the way I'm playing it right now. When I record, I don't have it on my TV. I play through my laptop, so I'm watching on a much smaller screen than if you were playing it normally. And that might be part of the problem here. They do have these green lights on the corners that are supposed to help you out. I just can't always see them until it's too late. But I should pay closer attention to those, I think. Like, this is the one that gets me. It says slow down and it shows the arrow thing, but it feels like it's really early. So I react a lot sooner than I should. My respect went down by 470. That's terrible. But yeah, so that's juiced. We don't need to do any more. Let's go ahead and quit. But yeah, I kind of like it. It's nothing I would ever play, but I don't hate it or anything. I don't have a lot of real bad things to say about it. Yeah, I'm sure. That was fun, though. Collect over 50 real cars and over 100 real modes. What? I don't know. Customize your baby in 7.5 trillion different ways. I can't read this. It's going by too fast. Wheel and deal your way through the tough streets of Saint. Get your crew together and show them who's boss. Do it for respect. Quote unquote respect. Risk your pride and joy in an Xbox Live showdown. So that's kind of cool. Play to the crowd with donuts, U-turns, and 360 show-offs. Yeah, once you know what you're doing, you can start doing tricks and stuff to get better respect. I think, like I said, I either hate THQ games or I think they're fine, and this was one that I thought was definitely fine. Man, there's a lot of legal information here. It feels like it's loading the same screen over and over again, but it's all this different information. Anyway, let's go ahead and move on to our next demo here. Alright, so our next game that we were supposed to play here was Xbox Live Arcade, but it's not working. And my theory is there's something with this Xbox where it doesn't like the Xbox Live demos, because we had the same problem last time we played Disc on here without Run 2, which was talking, like, the demo was hyping up, or the text here was hyping up that it had some Xbox Live stuff. But anytime I try to play this, it just resets my console. So unfortunately, I can't do it. On the plus side, though, unlike Outrun 2, this is all games that most people probably are familiar with. They're not full games. They're like games you would play on your phone or your iPad or something. These days, of course, not at the time when this was released. But anyway, so I guess we'll just call it quits, and I'll show you guys some video. We'll close it out here. Sure, we'll watch this Fantastic Four trailer that's playing in the corner right now. See you later.
Rated T for Teen.